blade hangs slightly below her jacket. Lynch indicates mockingly the couple of the piano. Kitty. Jay coughs behind her hand. She's a bit imbecilic. She signs with a waggling forefinger. Flemble. Lynch lifts up her skirt and white petticoat on the lawn. She settles them down quickly. Respect yourself. She hiccups. Then bends quickly her sailor hat under which her hair glows, red with comma. Oh, excuse. Zoe. More line my parrot Charlie. She goes to the chandelier and turns the gas lit off. Kitty. Here's a the gas jet. What ails it tonight? 474. Lynch. Meekly. Enter a ghost in Hobgoblin. Zoe. Clap on the back for Zoe. Vermont and Lynch's eyes and biases. A brass poker. Stephen stands at the pianola on which sprawled a Gatton ash plant. With two fingers he repeats once more the series off empty fifths. Lori Talbot, a blonde cable boot, at war in a lattered Italian gown of mildewed strawberry while spread eagle in the sofa corner, her limp forearm pendant over the bolster, listening, a heavy sigh droops over her sleepy eyelids. Kitty. Hiccups again with a kick at her horse foot. Oh, excuse. Zoe. Promptly. Your voice thinking of you. Tie a knot on your ship. Kitty Ricketts bends her head. Her boa uncoils. Slides over her shoulder, back, arm, chair to the ground. Lynch lifts the pearl caterpillar on his wand. She snakes her neck, nestling. Stephen glances behind at the squatted figure with its cap back to the front. Stephen. As a matter of fact, it is of no importance W. Luther Benedetto Marsh Paradio found in her maiden. The right of the poet's breast. It may be an old hymn to the meter or also illustrate Cicella and Aaron's Glorium Domini. It is susceptible of nodes or modes as far apart as Hypercrypian and Mixolydian and of texts so divergent as priests high-hooping round David's that his Thirsties are what am I saying series altar and David's tip from the table to his chief bassoonist about the alrightiness of his almightiness. Mage, nom de noni, that is another pair of trousers, e.e., Carrot Le Gourmet. Okay, Jonas say passe. He stops, points at Lynch's cap, smiles, laughs. Which side is your knowledge bump? The cap. With Saturnine spleen. Bah, it is because it is. Woman's reason. Jew Greek is Greek Jew. Extremes meet. Death is the highest form of life. Bah. 473. Stephen, you remember fairly accurately, eh? Gray errors, boasts, mistakes. How long shall I continue to close my eyes to the loyalty? Whetstone. The cap. Ma S. Stephen. Here's another for you. He frowns. The reason is because the fundamental and the dominant are separated by the greatest possible interval which. The cap. Which. Finish. You can't. Stephen. With an effort. Interval which. Is the greatest possible ellipse. Consistent with. The ultimate return. The octave. Which. The cap. Which. Outside the gramophone begins to blare the holy city. Stephen. A.H. Nisley. What went forth to the ends of the world to traverse not itself? God, the sun, Shakespeare, a commercial traveler, having itself traversed in reality itself becomes that self. Wait a moment, wait a second, damn that fellow's noise in the street. Self which it itself is ineluctable precondition. to become Echo Lynch. With a mocking weirdness of laughter grins as Alien and Zoe Higgins. What a learned speech, E.H. Zoe. Christly. God help your head, he knows more than you have forgotten. With obese stupidity, Glory Talbot regards Stephen. 476. Glory. They say the last day is pointing this summer. Kitty. No. Zoe. Explodes in laughter. Great unjust God I. Glory. It's C-I-D-E-D-S. Well, it was in the papers about Antichrist. Oh. My foot is tickling. Ragged barefoot newsboys jogging a luag tail kite, patter past, yelling. The KWS Bob. Stop press edition. Result of the rotten New York races. Sea serpent in the Royal Canal. Safe arrival of Antichrist. Stephen turns and sees Boom. Stephen. A time. Times and Ma time. Reuben J. Antichrist. Wandering Jew. A clutching hand open on his spine. Stumps forward. Across his loins is flung a pilgrim's wallet joy to you, which filtered promissory notes and dishonored bills. Aloft over his shoulder he bears a long boat pole from the hook of which the sodden huddled mass of his only son, safe from liquid waters, hangs from the slack of its breeches. A hobgoblin in the image of Punch Costello, Upshot, Perfacti, Hydrocephalic, frenetic with receding forehead and alley sloper nose tumbles and somersaults through the gathering. Darkness. What? All. The hobgoblin. His jaws chattering, papers dangling.